Alright guys, hello, my name is Kuzan and welcome to Lords of XCOM. This takes place in an alternate reality of Dongdank where the space race, as you guys might have known, actually takes off and peasants discover alien life. Unfortunately, this alien life that we encounter turns out to be our greatest threat rather than our greatest discovery as the aliens decide to invade our own planet. So now, the lords must team up with the peasants of Dongdank to try and save their city in this game. Now, I know what you're thinking. This isn't Minecraft. You're right. This is one of the first games that I've ever done that is not a Minecraft game. Ta-da! And fun fact, this is also the first time I've ever played XCOM Enemy Within. I've watched a few Let's Plays of it, so I know the basics, like I know about Meld, I know about the mechs, blah, 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 the class systems, and some of the different skill sets, but again, first time I've ever actually played it myself, which means I'm probably going to be doing a normal run. Now, also want to keep in mind that this is a roleplay game. So all the soldiers are going to be named after the lords and peasants in the game. We're dead. No, you're not going to die. You might die. You might die. Look, I'm going to be doing the best that I can to keep everybody alive, and I'm going to have a couple backups. Like, we're not going to be doing Iron Man, first of all. Obviously, we're going to make sure... Obviously, there's no way that we're going to actually, like, you know, go back and restart the mission every single time a person dies. Because that would just be fun. That wouldn't be fun, right? That wouldn't be fun. But... So, we're going to be playing on normal mode. Because, for obvious reasons, if you've ever played XCOM before, I've heard this multiple times... Normal mode is for beginners and for veterans alike. Classic mode would be way too difficult. It's 98% cheese. You are lying. Come on, guys. Come on. Let's be a bit more optimistic here. You haven't even seen me play the first part of the game. You are underestimating my abilities, and you insult me by doing so. Meh. Anyways. Oh, hey, Ender Inheritor. How's it going? But I'm very excited to get this going. Again, the soldiers will be named after the 10 lords, and they will be named after the people in the chat, the peasants themselves. So if you want to be a soldier in this game, join the chat, say hi. Keep in mind, I might not make you a soldier, and if you ask more than 3 times, I'm gonna make a note of you and put you on the never a soldier list. So don't spam it in the chat, okay? Don't be a dick. All right. Now that we've got all the technical mumbo jumbo aside, I'm sure that I missed something at this point, but I'm also going to be putting this up on the YouTubes for all of you guys to enjoy. So I hope you guys do enjoy it, whether you're watching in the stream as all of you lovely folks are right now, or here. Oh yeah, where's Science? Hang on a second. Can somebody do me a favor? One of you guys, Science might be on the Minecraft server. Can one of you guys go onto the server and find him and tell him, hey, we'd love to have you in here, because... We had, I was talking to Science about, being a mod of the channel. So, please, if somebody did that, that would be amazing. Alright, but I guess, enough chatting about me, let's go start this game off. Let's go single player. I'm gonna go to normal mode. Advanced options. We're actually gonna do, okay, here's something that I forgot. We're gonna do the 2 tutorials. And there's a reason for this. The reason is that I know that some of you guys might not, Yeah, Science Friction. How do you not know Science Friction, Frost? Sorry, Science Friction has helped me out with a couple of videos in the past. He was the waiter for my date with Mike, and he's been very, very helpful, and he loves XCOM, so I was talking to him about being a mod for the server as well. But anyway, that's not important. What is important is right up here. Now, I'm gonna do the tutorial for a couple reasons. One, I know that some of you guys haven't played this game either. Why not impossible? Huh, I wonder why not impossible, Jazzy. Huh. Some of you guys haven't played this game either, and I don't want you guys to be yelling at me for telling me, oh, you should have done this, you should have done that, if you don't know the game. So, if you want to learn how to play this game, you can go watch the first episode, this episode, or the second episode if the tutorial takes really, really long, and you can learn the game with me. That way, when, I don't know, in episode 14, and I mess up, or I make a smart choice that maybe... sacrifices a soldier, maybe before you tell me that what I did was wrong, you should go and check out the first episodes to make sure sure that you know what you're talking about. So, this is for you guys, and it's for me. Sorry. Also, I'm just kind of a sucker for story, and even though XCOM is clearly not a game about story, I still want to try and enjoy it. So, here we go. I believe that this is everything that I need to do. Let's get this show on the road. Start the game. Oh my god, I'm so excited! Alright. Those who play with the devil's toys will be brought by degrees to wield his sword. I'm talking really close into the microphone. Can you tell? Let's just let this play out, because I'm just so I want you to imagine those are all the Jimmies, all the peasants in Donden just running for their freaking lives. This is you right here. No! Jimmy, why? Why? Those poor fucking guys. Those poor guys. Rest in peace, man. Don't worry, we will avenge you.
Hello, Commander.
Hello, King Pooze.
In light of the recent extraterrestrial incursion,
your voice got deeper.
This Council of Nations has convened to approve the activation of the XCOM project. You have been chosen to lead this initiative. To oversee our first and last line of defense.
So the news reporter is now
your
the commander of the entire army. You didn't pick the actual general in the group. You didn't pick Willikers for this job.
Mind as you proceed.
You picked me. Okay.
Good luck, Commander.
So good. So excited for this. Alright. Let us begin. Now I just want to let you guys know there is one lord that is not going to be a soldier, and that is Electricity Man / Steve, because Steve is going
to
be Central Officer Bradford. Let's give a warm introduction to him.
We're being deployed to Germany. At 1900 hours Zulu, several unidentified objects fell to Earth. After ruling out the possibility of a downed satellite, we now believe these objects to be extraterrestrial in nature.
I thought we already knew that. That was the whole point of this whole group, right? Oh man, they're aliens!
And freak weather around one of the impact zones. Then things went dark. At 2100 hours, a chopper carrying a German military recon team went down in the area after they reported being fired.
Yes, la 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 la.
As you know, Germany is a member of the council, and they have requested our assistance.
Because remember, we only help the people who pay us money to help them.
Ascertain the current status of the German recon team and investigate the extraterrestrial objects.
Yes, investigate the aliens. All right, thank you very much. Central Officer Steve Bradford. Bradford's actually Steve, definitely not Electricity Man's middle name. It's Steve Bradford, definitely not Electricity Man. So, now we know.
Roger, Voodoo 3-1.
Oh, right. I'm so sorry, Boulder Dash. I mean, Steve. Sorry. Steve is going to be... No, out of character, I do have plans for who Electricity Man is going to be in this campaign, but it's not until much later. I kind of have a plan. I have a plan. Don't worry, guys. I have a plan. Please no yell. Oh, is it too loud now? Because people were yelling at me that it was too soft, so I don't know what to tell you, mate. Oh, get my leg on. Alright, this is a tutorial fight, so... so just, you're gonna have to give us a second. I'm just enjoying the fact that I'm playing the game on the stream right now. Oh my god, this is the best.
Whatever did this could still be out there.
This is the best in the whole world.
Take point. Take cover behind that debris directly in front of you.
Oh man, that is dark. Alright. Sorry guys, just give me a quick second. I gotta, up the brightness on this, there we go. Exit. Alright, awesome. Thank you!
Good.
Sorry guys, I'm playing on my, on my television, and the television was way too dark for me to see anything that was going on, so.
Delta 2, your turn. Move up to the debris.
Oh. Come on, man. Okay. Yes.
That thing isn't going to offer you much cover, but it's better than nothing. There's full cover straight ahead. Advance to that position.
I love
Delta 3.
From what I've seen, it's always smart to be in full cover no matter what. Sorry.
Central, I have movement. 30 meters north of my position. Police vehicle.
Oh, wait, no, no. It's just a bunny. Sorry. False alarm. Okay.
It's a long way from your position, and there's no available cover between
you. You know, I could sit at the car and then go over to that position if you really wanted me to, but okay. If you're sure. Here we go. Don't get too attached to these soldiers quite yet. They're just jimmies.
One of the recon team, sir. It looks like something.
Is that your man, Delta 4?
Negative, sir.
Now what makes
That's
me
someone else.
Yeah. Oh man, it's that bunny, Jazzy. It's definitely that bunny.
Being
Lord Redacted.
Me. That radio transmission.
You're gonna hate this woman after a while.
The squad's current position, based on its strength.
I'm sorry. I should not be playing a game that that I played. Hey, Disturbed. How's it going? Good to see you, mate.
And remember, stay in cover.
All right. Awesome. And advance over to that position. Alright. Alright. Okay, there we go.
Central, I got a lot of blood here.
Roger. See where it's coming from.
Central,
ooh.
I think I just found another one of the recon team.
Lovely.
Left of him.
It's a.
This doesn't make sense.
Like the I like the little trail in the middle of I think it's his intestine. Very nice image you got there. It's artistic.
When something burst out of him from the inside.
Sir,
yeah, we're in
I
Germany somewhere. Stucka.
Permission to approach.
It's the only cover between you and that building. Permission granted.
All right. Let's take a look at what this thing is. You know, I never actually
soldier.
They never
what
really
is,
stated what
no
these things really
thing
are.
Thing
I think they're
is.
Since we saw the guy get sucked
no
into one, I guess they're alien abduction kits, but hang on,
Roger.
But that does that mean
right,
that they're,
You're almost to the building. Keep moving.
That they take in,
half a dozen
bodies and just pull them into the unit and just keep them there?
Delta
what happened if you opened
window.
One of those things? What would be
Let's
inside? Creepy thoughts, creepy thoughts. And no, Tombstone, they're not alien Nazis, because if they were alien Nazis, then they'd be coming from Germany now, wouldn't they? The Germans are the victims here. And why you gotta be so rude? Too soon!
Delta 2, that door's in our way. Take it down.
Oh.
Solid copy.
I love how intense he is. That door's in our way. Take it down! The reason I picked Steve to be Bradford is because Steve's always the serious one of the group. He's pretty much like he's all business and doesn't really like to mess around too much. So it seemed to make perfect sense that he would be he'd be Bradford. For this.
Central, we have eyes on the target. He's armed.
Copy, Delta 3. Okay, everyone, get into position nearby. but do not approach.
To be honest, I do approve with all the things that he's doing.
See if you can communicate with him. Tell him to drop his weapon.
I will try. Hello. Können Sie mich hören?
All right, still not doing anything.
Wir sind hier, Ihnen zu helfen. Bitte lassen Sie Ihre Waffen fallen.
Actually, there is one thing that I disagree with, is putting them on Overwatch. But that's not part of the tutorial now, is it? Oh my god. Hey guys, can you,
I don't like the looks of this.
Hey guys, you might want to,
Delta 3, move in and disarm him. Carefully.
Alright, here we go. He's been at a rave for way too- Nope. It's very different. It's very different.
What the hell is going on?
Jimmy News! Bradford! I mean, Steve! I'm sorry. Steve, you killed us! Oh god, no shit.
Delta 1 is down.
Okay.
This guy's got me pinned down.
That got really bad. That got really bad, really, really fast. Okay. Yes. Right there. Yes, Steve. Whatever you say.
Alright, Delta 2. Weapons free. Get ready to fire.
Let's enter tactical combat. Gotcha. Take the shot. Yeah.
Nice shot. Delta 4, you're freed up to move. Get out of there and get into cover.
Alright.
Now toss your grenade at the enemy in front of you.
Alright, grenade. Again, I was doing tests for the stream, so I do know the basic controls. Dude, I played this tutorial so many fucking times. So I might be spoiling some things, but man, I'm just...
Now get ready for the counterattack. Look out, Delta 4. There's another one coming in behind you.
That's not
Let's
good.
Let's tip the odds in our favor. Look around for a position where you can flank the enemy. That's it. You have a clear shot from that position. Fire.
And come on. All right, are we done?
I think that's it. It's over.
Sniper shot. No sniper shot? Oh, okay.
Roger
okay, Steve,
that, Delta.
Take us home.
Secure the bodies and head back to the Sky Ranger for immediate extraction.
Steve, you are the worst general. My god, you killed 3 of our 4 party members. You suck. It's not my fault. Not my fault, right? You have to wait another, 30 minutes until I start killing people, alright? That was all Steve. Alright, now we have... Oh, what? We don't get all the countries? No. Okay. So basically, you can choose what continent your country is on. You can choose North America or Europe. But I like to do Africa. Is usually my favorite because so here's the different things. Air and space. All aircraft and aircraft weapons cost 50% less to purchase, build and maintain. Great. That's wonderful. Europe, laboratories and workshops, which is great for advancing your technology and building more things in general. Asia, foundry and officer training school. I know those things are important, but I am having a little bit of trouble remembering them because, again, this is the first time I've played this game. We have, I love this one, autopsies and interrogations are completed instantly. We have ways. Anyways, and then, but Africa, it helps you out the most. Monthly XCOM funding for everything is increased by 30%, so you can do more of anything and direct that wherever you want. So I'm kind of sad that I only get 2 options here. To be honest, I want to go with aircraft weapons cost 50% less. Don't look at me, Steve. Go away. Shoo. I'm gonna go with Europe. Mostly because while Aaron's space is wonderful and we do need them to shoot them down, that's not going to help us in the immediate long run. Laboratories and workshops will. The reason is that the more laboratories and workshops will give you more scientists and engineers. More scientists and engineers mean you can research things faster and build things faster, and we're going to need the equipment. So I'm going to go with Europe for this one. Don't judge me again. Anyways.
Affirmative. We are coming home.
Yeah. I want to give that guy a name. Let me know if you want to be the pilot. Because that would be awesome. You are terrible. Alright. Is it weird to me that I,
What?
Never mind.
Are they?
Whatever they are,
you'll get a formal introduction to the two guys on Steve's left and right.
Excuse me,
doctor. By the way, you can.
The commander
is
waiting in mission control.
Screw that. Screw that noise. You know what? We're gonna. Have people assigned to all the characters.
Then
if you want to be these two,
cut out for us,
you can also give me a let DEN know, and we'll see what we can do.
Welcome to XCOM HQ, Commander.
Hello, Steve.
I'm Central Officer Bradford.
Yeah, Steve Bradford, definitely not electricity man.
Providing tactical support for our field operations and keeping you briefed on the current situation. My efforts should allow you to focus on the bigger issues at hand.
Zymorm, you're not going to be pilot because I got a special idea for you.
I'll let you get to it.
I've got something already set up for you, but we'll talk later. Anyways, welcome to XCOM headquarters. This is where we do all of our wonderful stuff.
Barracks.
So I'm just gonna, if I do anything else during this time, they're gonna nag me from the computer's gonna nag me, so I'm just gonna go and do what they wanna do, and then we'll start working on creating the Lords!
Commander, the soldier is waiting for you in the armory, which is located there in the barracks.
Hello, Kobe King, how you doing?
Only one recruit from Delta Squad made it back.
Okay,
alive from
we have
mission,
a heavy.
Commander.
So, according to my little sheet here, Willikers. Alright,
As you know, Commander, every
soldier
is
different. This
particular
soldier
has shown
his aptitude for
heavy weapons. As he gains additional combat experience, we should continue his training along these lines. This soldier will now carry a rocket launcher in addition to his standard weapon. The aliens won't know what hit him.
All right, guys. No, Nisso is not going to be the medic.
Dr. Vollen asked to see you in the research labs, Commander. It sounded important.
I don't get a break, do I?
Commander, to the research lab.
All right. Hello, let's meet Dr. Vollen, or she's going to be
Hello, Commander.
Or
my name is Dr. Vollen.
Somebody else.
I oversee the research
labs. What is your first name? That's the question.
This is where all of XCOM's research and development takes place. We have already begun analyzing the artifacts recovered from our first encounter with the aliens. Based on our preliminary findings, we believe we can use them to develop some new equipment for our soldiers. With your approval, we will begin research immediately.
Oh man, that's some profound wisdom, Frost. Alright, so let's take a look here. Weapons fragments and alien materials. They require the same amount of time and they require the same amount of materials. 5 weapon fragments. So I believe that what we do here is that a cursory examination for ways to improve the soldier's current body armor. So do we want better weapons or better armor? My choice? Better armor. I want to keep you guys alive. So we're going to go with alien materials.
Thank you, Commander. This research will take some time. We will notify you once it is complete.
McCartan, I'm sorry that you're lagging.
Commander to mission control. Commander to
it sounds
control.
Like you are needed elsewhere. Farewell, Commander. If you recover any additional artifacts during your field operations, I would be quite eager to study them.
Commander to mission control.
Thank you. All right, let's go to mission control now.
The enemy is testing our capabilities,
Wait,
Commander.
We're on a mission?
We've gotten reports of simultaneous attacks in 2 different countries.
Oh, shit.
We can only respond to
we
one.
We haven't even got to name our
the
soldiers yet.
Help
Come on, Steve,
donate
give me a
more
break.
Resources to our cause. But the panic level of the country we choose not to help will rise. It's not an easy decision, Commander, but it's one you'll have to make.
Oh, great. All right. Here we go then. View abduction sites. Alright, so the United States or China. Okay, they're both easy. And they are both on low panic levels, so we don't have to worry about that too much. So let's take a look at what we can get from these. And don't... Alright. For scientists or $200? Oh, crud. Here's the problem. I don't know what exactly $200 means because I haven't played this game enough to know how valuable that is. Like, is $200 small? Is $200 big? I don't know. So my question is, you know what? Do I want to defer for chat for this one? Because I'm a little bit concerned on this. Wait, science is here? Where's science? Okay, I gotcha. Yes, I gotcha. I got it, man. Hang on a second. Scientists will make you money. Oh, okay, gotcha. Cypher, you're... Oh, of course you are. There you go. There you go. You are now a mod. Congratulations. I'm so sorry, man. I didn't know. I'm dumb. Sounds kind of crummy for help with aliens. Dude, I don't know how much 200 credits is. Tell you what. Let's go with a scientist for now. I want to be able to develop research as fast as possible. Alright, let's do it then. Confirm, let's move out.
Understood. The troops are waiting for you in the hangar.
Thank you.
Commander, before deploying our squad, you can choose which soldiers to send out there.
Wait a minute, can we edit the units?
The liberty of calling up our veteran.
Yes! We can edit the units! Okay, okay. Okay, here we go. Oh wait, so this is a heavy, so we're gonna call you Shane Deadbones. Alright guys, we have our first lord. Enough to put up a straw poll, and then yes, and then I ignored it like a derp because I wasn't checking the chat. I'm sorry. Anyways, I think this is pretty good for Mr. Deadbones. Hopefully he doesn't die, because keep in mind I'm not gonna be renaming anybody, so you need to stay alive. The rest of you guys, as lovely as it would be, I'm gonna be picking out who are the lords based upon their class. So rookies don't get a class. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have these guys go out as themselves, just as they are right now, and name them as the lords. We're gonna be doing the lords first, and then we'll start doing peasants. So right now, just hold off on your soldier naming. We'll get to that in a bit. But for now, here we go. Launch the mission. Oh boy, here we go. Wait a minute. I can't equip that thing. Launch the mission. Here we go with our first mission! Screw you, Frost, man. I looked at the chat and then you. And when I looked away, you uploaded the straw poll. I'm sorry, it was bad timing. All right, come on. Oh man, this is my first one. I don't want to kill Deadbones. Don't kill Deadbones. Just remember, don't kill them. Actually, we don't want anybody to die, because remember, these guys are lords in training. I can't equip them.
Hold on, soldier.
Kijibit, I didn't equip them. I have nothing to equip them with.
Your squad mate is closer, so let him check
it
out.
So, Texver already said what I was gonna say, so. Alright, so apparently. Steve, are you still taking control of this? Dear God, man. You're gonna kill. If you kill Deadbones, I swear to God.
Reveal your position to the enemy. Okay.
Alright.
Now take cover inside.
Full cover, good.
Alright.
Now I want a man on the roof of that building. See if you can find a way up there, soldier.
All right, let's go over here. If I've been drinking tea, no, but I've been drinking rum and coke. No, I'm just kidding.
The rest of you, advance toward the enemy and get into cover. Hold your fire until I give the
word. It's a new mic, actually. So you get into cover. Oh, wait a minute, I have freedom? Oh my god, this is the best day ever. All right, so you're gonna go here. Hold your fire, so we're gonna go on Overwatch. And you're gonna go over... Can I be flanked from here? No, I cannot be flanked from here. I'm gonna find out what that straw... Oh shit! Missed? Missed, okay. Whew! Thank goodness. Alright, so this is something I know. Okay. I am in America, for your information. Double slab. I am. Okay, so just a quick heads up, guys. 68% means that, well, they're both 68%, but you also have to, oh wait, no, 152. And the reason is, that guy is in full cover. That guy is only in half, and you always want to go for the guy in half cover. So let's take that opportunity. Yeah! There you go. Awesome. Firing from an elevated position increases the soldier's chance to hit. Good to know, good to know. Alright, do I really want to go in that room? There could be aliens in there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to open this up. And then if there are, nothing. Okay, awesome. Now I could get a nice shot on that alien from here. Not sure if that's the best way to go about it though. Oh, I could toss a grenade over there. That would be good. Toss the grenade. Can I hit him? I can. That would be amazing. Because then there's no... Hang on a second. Actually, let's see how... Our only 31% chance to hit. It's much safer if we do, if we take a grenade.
Suck on this.
Yeah!
Commander will be assuming command now as you sweep the rest of the area. As always, I'll be offering tactical advice as needed. And remember, your armor can only withstand a couple of shots from their weapons. So keep your eyes open and your heads down.
Okay.
Good luck.
Awesome. Oh. Alrighty then. Sounds good. Ignore that, please. Cruise on for the most collateral damage. Come on, it's not that bad. Look, nobody died. That's important, right? That's right. Alright, so we're gonna move up here. Alright, so now I'm finally in command. This is good. Alright. Let's go, Suzuki, you're on Overwatch. I'm gonna move you up to here, which is really, really good. That's a really, really good position to be in. Alright, let's search for alien activity. Nothing. Okay. Huh. Well, that's something to keep in mind. Okay. Now, question is, can I go into that area? It doesn't look like that area is actually part of the field. I'm gonna take, instead of taking Shane, I mean Dead Bones, I'm gonna take you. Actually, no, I'm gonna take you up to here. I don't know. Let's, I don't know. Okay. Alright, let's see if we look at this.
That's affirmative. There.
She hasn't had her second action yet, so I wanna...
That's affirmative.
I wanna have you on Overwatch here. For sure. Alright, and then we scroll down to you. I want you over in full cover. I always want them in full cover, no matter what. Oh man, there is no full cover. Dang it. And we're gonna keep Dead Bones where he is. Alright, and she's safe up there. That way I can use all of them to fan out more. And you're gonna stay right where you are. Okay, no activity. Still no activity yet, which is really starting to bug me because I would like to see some aliens and where they are so I can deal with them properly. Alright, let's move you. Spot something? Nothing? Really? What does this map go for? Oh, it goes a ways. Alright, we need to start moving. We definitely need to start moving. Alright, so let's move you up to... No, I don't want you...
Heading there now.
Don't want you going anywhere. Without a... Alright. Oh, there's full cover up there. I like that. And then she'll have your back. Alright, now you are gonna dash. Sorry about that, guys. You are gonna dash. Oh, this is probably an area where there's gonna be aliens as well. So let's put you here.
Moving to position.
And overwatch you. And now I'm gonna. Now Dead Bones is too far away from the party, so I'm gonna dash him up to you to here. Awesome. Booming. Oh boy. Yeah, double blood. What the? I'm sorry. Here I am playing a game, and I just look at that chat, and all I see is double bloody nose all the way across my face. Frost, what the fuck are you talking about? Anyways, Dead Bones, you're gonna go up and check it out. Ah! Oh, we see one. We see something. You're going on Overwatch? You are going to go ahead and pull this Overwatch? Overwatch. And now you... I don't want to split up the party. So you are gonna go here. I'm playing this very safe, as you can see. Because I don't want anyone to die. You have too little faith, because I won't prove you guys wrong. You're like, oh, she's gonna kill everyone.
Veteran's rocket launcher should make easy work of the structure the aliens are using for cover.
Ooh.
And if we're lucky, it'll take out the aliens along with it. That is, if it hits.
If it hits. Rockets have a 90% chance to hit, which is good, but it's not great. Alright, so Dead Bones... I need you to not get detected by the aliens. They spotted us. Shit. Alright, hang on a second. Alright, I need backup for him. I need backup for him right now.
Getting it done.
Yeah. Oh yeah, there's no way. Put you on Overwatch. Oh, half cover over there. That's a good vantage point. But she's a little bit far away from the group, so I won't put her up there. Sorry guys, this is not, it's still really good at picking up background noise, which means that little kid in the front, oh my god. Anyway, just ignore that for right now. I'm just really nervous. I'm very, very nervous. I don't want to take too many risks right now. I don't want to put her up on the roof either. So you're just going to go over here and not do too much at the moment. Okay, whew. They're powering him up. That's great. You're gonna take a shot at him from way over there? You're dumb. Well, maybe not as dumb as I thought. Alright, Here we go. Take the shot, Dead Bones. What? No! I can't fire the weapon in the same turn? Oh, shit. Alright, overwatch him. Everybody else, follow up. Follow up quick. Follow up quick. Oh, no, 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 no. This is not good at all.
Overwatch, aye, aye.
Alright. You follow up to him. Back him up. Back him up. We have no cover over here. Oh boy, we have no cover over here. Do we have a shot? Nope. Overwatch it again. Alright, and you are gonna go here. And do I have any chance in hell? You know what? Fine, let's see if it works. Of course not. Why would it ever work?
Shot wide.
Trying to take another shot. Okay, okay.
You're okay, soldier. But another one like that, and that'll be the end of you. Make sure to stay in cover.
I hate living in this neighborhood.
Aim carefully, soldier. You only get one shot.
All right. Now, that little glowing thing, those two glowing dots, the two aliens, and I've got them both well within range. Now, I want to make sure that this thing hits. Let's do it!
Lanzando.
Yeah! End game.
Good work,
oh, that was it?
If I may, Commander, the labs are on high alert.
That was anticlimactic.
Standing by for your orders. We can begin researching the newly
That was very anticlimactic. Alright guys, well we successfully completed our first mission! Awesome! Yay! It's been mostly tutorial missions from this point on, but I think this is where the tutorial actually ends. So congratulations everyone, we made it and Dead Bones didn't die! Excellent! Boom shakalakalaka boom shakalakalaka boom shakalakalaka boom boom boom. So we have our heavy and we're ready to head back home. Alright guys. For those of you on the YouTubes, I'm going to call it here for the first long, long episode. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys will continue to stay tuned. Until then, I will see you in the next video. Since this is no longer the news, I cannot say good night and good luck. But I'll see you next time. You guys have a good night. Bye-bye.